So I'm talking to Richard Shaffer, oncologist who treats Dupuytren's disease with radiotherapy. Richard, how do people know if it's too early to start radiotherapy treatments? And when should they make that decision to come and talk to you?
Okay, so we know that for people who have early disease, where it's progressing, that's the time where you might be eligible for radiotherapy. So let's go through that a little bit. So in terms of knowing you have Dupuytren's disease, you know, obviously that needs to be seen by a medical professional, ideally either a hand surgeon or a radiation oncologist who's experienced. So you need to have evidence of disease, and that really can be done just by looking at the hand, taking a history. You don't need scans. In terms of whether it's early, what that means is that you don't have a significant contracture. So if your fingers are bent over by, let's say, more than 10 degrees or so, then that's too advanced to have radiotherapy. So it has to be early. In other words, either your fingers are still straight or they have a very minor contracture. When I use the word progressive, what I mean is that it's getting worse. So early progressive disease means that you don't have a significant contracture and that it's getting worse. So what happens when someone has their first nodule? They come to me and they say, it's been there for 2 weeks, it's hurting, I'm really worried about this, you know, what should I do? Well, for those people, you know, although they have early disease, it's not clear yet whether it's progressing, in other words, whether it's worsening. And so therefore, we have to watch and wait over time to see whether in fact it's getting worse, and therefore whether those people become eligible for treatment. And there are three things that I say that you should do. Number one, feel the nodule and the cord, draw around it with a felt tip pen, put a ruler by that on your hand, and then take a photo. That will then give you the baseline for what your nodules look like and what the cords, the lines going to the fingers or down to the wrist, what they look like. And of course, if over time you notice that things have worsened, in other words, you've got a new nodule, a new cord, the cord has extended, the nodule's got bigger, then that would obviously be a deterioration in what's going on and you should come talk to me about treatment. So that's the first thing, the extent of the nodules and cords on the palm of the fingers. The second thing that you should do is look for what's called loss of hyperextension. So if you put your hand on a table, you'll see that if I press on this knuckle where the hand meets the finger, then you'll be able to lift your finger by a certain amount. Now, lots of that's called hyperextension. If you lose hyperextension, you won't be able to lift up your finger so much. The distance between the tip of your finger and the table should be measured. So remember, put your finger on the knuckle, lift your finger up as much as you can, measure between the tip of the finger and the table, and you do that for all fingers on both hands. Again, if that deteriorates so that any finger is significantly less able to lift up from the table, then that will be a loss of hyperextension, and that shows that things are progressing, and therefore you should come and talk to me about treatment. The third thing that I would like you to do is put your hands like this, spread your fingers as much as possible, including your thumbs, put it down on a piece of paper, draw around all your fingers on a piece of paper like this, and then that gives you a baseline for your finger span. So in other words, how far your fingers are able to extend out to the sides, including your thumb. Again, if you do that over time, you notice a deterioration. In other words, that things are getting worse so that your fingers are less able to extend outwards, then you'll know that there's a deterioration. Do that every month or every 2 months. Generally, every month will be fine, but do not do it more often. If over time, let's say over 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 months, however long it takes, you notice that things are getting worse in any of those three measures significantly, then come and talk to me about treatment. If, however, things stay stable, then that means that you're watching and waiting and that you know that things do not need treatment at the moment.
That sounds really good. Easy to do at home and useful for patients.
Good.